Well, hello and welcome to today's reading, testimony number 8, and it's entitled Under the Weather, Caring for the Unwell and a Helping Hand. It's written by a lady called Jenny, who has 2 sons, lives in London and is a project manager for British Telecom. The Bible verses today, they come from Mark 2, verses 1 to 5. And when he returned to Capernaum after some days, it was reported that he was at home. And many were gathered together so that there was no more room, not even at the door. And he was preaching the word to them. And they came bringing to him a paralytic carried by 4 men. And when they could not get near him because of the crowd, they removed the roof above him. And when they had made an opening, they let down the bed on which the paralytic lay. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven." Coughs and sneezes, or assigned to bed if you live alone, it can be difficult to manage cooking or even making a drink. And if others depend on you, there's the pressure to carry on, regardless of how ill you feel. Someone you know is going through a hard time with their health, so put aside time to help them in a practical way, especially with the circumstances at the moment. Years ago, I read a book called The 5 Love Languages by Gary Chapman. It completely opened my eyes to the different way we all give and receive love. The 5 languages break down to quality time, gifts, acts of service, physical touch, and words of affirmation. I am an acts of service girl. It's the way I show love. I never hesitate to lend a helping hand to someone, whether it's by cooking a meal or cleaning their house or any kind of practical help. It definitely comes natural to me. That being said, I'm not the best at receiving help because I'm such a doer. But early in 2019, I was diagnosed with breast cancer and was told I'd have to undergo a grueling amount of chemotherapy treatment spanning several months. With 2 children under 5 years old and my husband having to work, I immediately began to worry about how I might cope and do the practical things I needed to do as a mum and wife, as well as focusing on getting better. It felt impossible, and I really didn't know how and where to reach out for help. Amazingly, my friends and family rallied around me in a way I can only describe as incredible. They cooked meals, accompanied me to every single chemo session, cleaned my house, did my food shopping, looked after my boys, did school pickups. I mean, you name it, nothing was too difficult. Just like the friends of the paralytic man in Mark's Gospel, they went out of their way to support me and my family. I can't express just how much that helped me at a time I really could do very little for myself. I appreciate every text and phone call, just checking in and making sure I was okay. It doesn't matter what it is. We all have the capacity to do something. It may seem so small to you, but to the recipient, you've taken a load off their shoulders and reminded them that they're not alone. Some years ago, my wife Joy went through the trials of chemo and radiotherapy, and it was a really tough time. Throughout, we were so grateful for the thoughts and prayers of many friends and church family. We particularly remember the many acts of kindness, meals, coffee meetings, calls and messages that let us know that other people cared enough to support us through that difficult journey. We all experience difficult times, so let's consider today's challenges. Even though we might have to be a bit more creative because of the restrictions that we're all facing at the moment, but we can all show somebody that we care and remember them. So the challenge is today. Text or call somebody you know who is unwell to see how they are doing. Create a care package or ask someone if they'd like you to prepare a meal for them. Set aside some time for a visit or relieve someone who cares for a relative full time for a couple of hours. That is obviously more difficult, but one to bear in mind. They're simple things we can do that make a big difference. Thank you. Join us again tomorrow. Bye.